Grunstock Gunhauler is a small, agile and fast escort vessel that makes a valuable addition to any Kharadron Overlord fleet. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint one in the colour scheme of Barak-Nar, which is the scheme that you can see on the box. Now, whilst we are going to be painting the Gunhauler in this video, you can easily adapt all the methods and techniques we're going to show you to paint any of the Kharadron Overlord Skyvessels. It's just that the other ones are bigger. Now, also, the only part of the kit we're not going to paint in this video is the crew. And the reason for this is because we've already covered them in a really in-depth video on how to paint Kharadron Overlord Arkanauts, because, well, they're identical. But with all that out of the way, let's get started because, well, I've been really looking forward to painting one of these ships. Before we start to do any painting, I just want to quickly run you through the various sub-assemblies that I've built the kit in. What I've got is the entire hull built here, but not yet glued to its flying stand. I've got the crew separate so I can get to all the detail on them, and then also I've got the engine separate, and this is just so it doesn't get in the way of all the detail on top of the ship's hull. Now, the first detail we're going to start painting in is all the bronze and gold details, and there's quite a lot of these, and some of them quite intricate, so we just make life easy for ourselves if we start with these details. The colour to begin with is Balthazar Gold, and as always, remember to give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour, especially the metallics, and I'm going to be starting to apply this using a medium base brush, good sized brush for the kind of details we want to do. Now, throughout this video, I'm going to be using a palette, which is really, really useful. I always recommend you use one because it allows you to get lots of control over your paint. What we need is some of this here, and then to add a small amount of water to it. Be careful with these brushes because they do tend to drop a lot of water quickly. You don't need very much. You just need to mix it in there like that to get about this sort of consistency before you start applying it to your miniature. Now, I'm going to start by painting on the bronze figurehead on the front of the ship, but you want to do both the gold and the bronze at the same time here. And you don't need to worry about being neat. All you've got to do is make sure you cover the details that you want to paint. Don't worry about the other ones just yet, because we are going to neaten up as we add further colours to the miniature. Now, you want to make sure that this bronze is a good strong colour before you move on to the next step. So what I recommend you do is apply one coat like this, let it dry, then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way, because doing so will ensure that colour's really strong and bright and ready for the next step. I've finished applying all the Balthazar Gold to all the bronze and gold details on the hull, and you can also see I've done the same thing on the engine as well. And with that done, we're now ready to move into the next colour, which is going to be all the silver details. Now, the base paint for this is going to be Lead Belcher, and this I'm going to be applying this time using a medium layer brush, because now we need to be much more careful about where exactly we're applying it, because we've got to work in amongst all that bronze and gold, you see. So as before, use your palette, thin your paint down, so you've got lots of control over it this time, and make sure you've not overloaded your brush. You don't need loads of paint on it this time. And I've got a great example here of the kind of area to be careful on, because I built this one with a sky cannon on the front of the hull here. So it's silver in between all this bronze here. So what you need to do is just be neat as you're applying it, go up to it carefully like that, but otherwise just fill in the rest of the area. As before, you'll want to get a good finish here, so you'll need to apply two thin coats. And this silver is scattered all over the miniature. So if you're not sure which bits to paint in, then I recommend you use the box art, the book, and also the website as well to find which parts you want to paint silver. I've finished base coating with Lead Belcher now, and you can see I've finished with it on the engine as well, and now we're ready for the next step. But before we do that, if you haven't already, I recommend you change your water, because so far we've used a lot of metallic paint, and we're just painting the small ship. If you're doing the big one, the Ironclad, you'll have used a lot by this point, and therefore you'll see lots of little metal flecks floating around in your water. Now, in large quantities like this, this can start to contaminate your other paints as well, so it's a good idea to clean your water before any of that happens. But once you've done that, we're ready to start adding some shade to our miniature, and we're going to go for Agrax Earthshade here to give a kind of oily, grimy appearance. Now, I'm going to be applying this over all the metallics I've done so far, and on the hull I'm going to use a medium shade brush, but on the engine you might want to go for a large shade brush instead because it's so much bigger. What you need to do is just put some of the shade onto your palette like this so you can gauge exactly how much you're going to be applying at once. You will need quite a lot at once though, so get plenty loaded on your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting this over all the metal parts you've done so far. Don't worry about other details yet, because we will neaten up those as we go along, but when you're applying large quantities like this, you can see it all tends to run quite a lot, especially towards the bottom of the miniature. So keep an eye on that. If you're seeing excess paint building up, just move away with your brush before it dries. Otherwise, you can get quite a nasty effect appearing. But as long as it's still wet, it's quite easy to move away. Once you apply this all over your metallics, give it plenty of time to dry. In this case, about an hour will do the job. The shade's now completely dry, helping to pick out all that detail and adding lots of depth to all those metallic parts. But as it dries, you may notice in some parts some tide marks appearing, particularly the larger, smoother parts. For example, the top of the engine dome here, you can see some of them showing just there. Don't worry about it though, because we will neaten this up as we go on later on. Because now it's time to start picking out all the gold details, and for this what you need is Gehenna's Gold. I'm going to be applying this mostly using a medium layer brush, but it's a good idea to have a small layer brush on hand, because you will need it for some finer parts. But what you're looking to do is to use your palette once again to get the paint under control. Definitely thin it down with a little bit of water. You're looking for about this sort of consistency, like this, and you want to get a fine tip in your brush so you've got lots of control. Now, it's entirely up to you which parts exactly you pick out with the gold here, but for all these cases, what you want to do is look for the recessed details where shade has settled and avoid them. So, for example, the figurehead on here, you can see those channels where the shade settled in between those hairs on the beard down here. So, what I'm going to do is just avoid those parts, picking out the flatter areas around them like this. So just take your time picking out as many bits now with gold as you like. Once you've picked out all those gold details, we're ready to start highlighting all these metallics. And we're going to first of all highlight all the gold and the bronze at the same time using Cycorax Bronze. Then we're going to move on to Necron Compound to highlight all metallics at the same time. Now, Cycorax Bronze is a layer paint, but it's ideal for purposes here because we want a nice soft highlight on it, particularly on the flatter parts of the bronze on top of the endrin. So I'm going to be using a medium dry brush to apply this. You might want to have a small dry brush on hand though for a bit more control. And what we do is get a little bit of the paint on your brush and make sure it's all thoroughly mixed before you do this. Get some tissue and start working the paint in amongst the bristles there like that. You don't need very much. You want to get rid of most of the paint, so there's only a small bit left on the brush there like that. And when you're ready, what we're going to do is start dry brushing onto both the bronze and the gold at the same time with quite a particular technique here. What I'm going to do is start applying it in round motions like this to softly start building up the colour. And you can see doing this is going over that sort of that tide mark we've got from showing from the shade earlier on and starting to even it out there like that. But also it's catching quite a lot on all the edges too. So what you need to do now is carry on doing this across all the bronze and gold. Don't worry if you catch some of the silver, because we will neaten that up when we're dry brushing the silver afterwards, but be as neat as you can and minimize it as best you can. Once you've finished dry brushing with Cycorax Bronze, it's now time to start dry brushing using Necron Compound. And this is for all the metallics this time, and the technique is very slightly different. What you want to do is just focus with a bit more control on all the sharpest corners, like I'm doing along here, to pick these details out with a nice highlight. And once you've finished applying that dry brush, you can see you're left with a really nice metallic effect. And at this stage, if you want to, you can take it just a little bit further. You don't have to, but if you want to, what you need is Stormhost Silver. And we're just going to use this to pick out a few details to make them stand out a little bit more. Now, I'm going to be applying this using a small layer brush. And what you want to do here is use your palette to get the paint under control, because we want to be very focused here about where exactly we apply it. So put some paint onto your palette, as always, and then add a little bit of water in there, slightly more than we've been doing so far, so it's a little bit thinner. And you just make sure you don't have too much on your brush. You want a fine tip on the bristles here. Now, you can pick out as many details here as you like, but I'm going to focus on the figurehead and also the controls as well. And what I'm looking to do is looking carefully at the dry brushing, I'm looking for any lines that have started to come out from it. So we've got some on the brow here on the figurehead, so what I'm going to do is just paint along that there like that to make it a little bit sharper, just to finish off this detail there like that. Now that highlight's been applied, we're ready to move on to the next area of colour, which is going to be all the burgundy parts. Now for this, we need to start out with a base coat of Screamer Pink, and then we'll shade over these parts with Norn Oil before adding a highlight of Pink Horror. But starting out with Screamer Pink, I'm going to be doing this mostly with a medium base brush, but it's a good idea to have a small layer brush in hand, because you will need it for some of the finer details here. And as always, use your palette to get this paint ready, and well, these details are scattered all over the miniature, so if you're not sure which parts exactly to do them, once again, just check out the box art and that will guide you. But for all these parts, you've got to be careful, because now we need to work amongst all the metallics that we've done so far. So for example, if I start up towards the front here, I want to paint in this area with this colour, but as I get close to that gold there on the figurehead, I'm just going to be really careful and work my way up to that recess there like that. And on these open areas here, you will need to apply two thin coats as well. Once you finish the base coat, you're now ready to shade all the Screamer Pink by using Norn Oil. Now, when you're applying this, be careful not to put on loads at once, because you don't want it to pool towards the bottom of these areas. Instead, keep it fairly thin and keep moving it so it's nice and smooth like this. See, as it dries, it stays nice and even. Once the shade's completely dry, you're ready to start highlighting using Pink Horror. Now for this, sometimes you'll have to be really neat as you pick out these sharp edges on the armour. For example, just along here, you want to just run the colour as neatly as possible along the edge there like that. But sometimes these corners are really pronounced, such as up here for example. In these cases, what you can do, just hold your brush at an angle just against that part and just lightly run it along there like that, and you get a nice neat highlight really quickly. Also, during this stage, be sure to pick out all the rivets as well. And there we go, all the burgundy details are complete and we're ready for the next area of colour, which is going to be all the cream parts. And for this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Zandri Dust, then we'll layer over these parts using a Shabti Bone. After that, we'll shade the recesses with Agraxer Shade, and then we'll finish off with a highlight of Screaming Skull. But we're going to start out with our base coat of Zandri Dust, and this time we're going to apply it almost entirely using a medium layer brush, because now we need to be much more careful as we work around the burgundy we've completed so far. So again, use your palette to help you control the paint, so you want to thin it down to about that point there, and when you're ready, make sure you don't have too much on your brush, Because as you're applying it, you need to be really careful now as you're going against that burgundy pass. Actually, it helps if you orientate the miniature like this, so you're painting in vertical lines, so you can be really neat as you're painting that area there. Then fill out the rest, and remember, just be careful around all the gold detail as well. And with this colour, you'll need to apply two thin coats. Once you've finished base coating with Zandri Dust, you're now ready to layer over these details using a Shabti Bone. Once again, apply just two thin coats and using the same method as well. Next, you're ready to apply a recessed shade of Agrax Earthshade applied using a small layer brush. And be as neat as you can as you do this. If you do make any mistakes, just neaten up with a Shabti Bone before you continue. And be sure to pick out all the rivets at this stage as well. And once that shade's dry and neatened up, you're now ready to apply a highlight, a Screaming Skull. Now, this is an edge highlight, so on the fins, you just want to use the side of your brush just to pick out the sharpest parts like this. But be sure to pick out all the rivets as well. And there we go, that's all the cream details completed, and now we're ready for the next major area of colour, which is going to be all the black details. And for this, all you need is a Baden Black for the base coat, and then we're going to highlight these parts using Eshin Grey. So starting with our base coat, I'm going once again for my medium layer brush, and for this case you need lots of control once again over the paint. So still use your palette to thin the paint down, so it's flowing really easily, and that you've got lots of control over it. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start picking these details out. I'm going to start on this one on the underside of the hole just down here, and as before, be careful whenever you get close to those details that you completed so far. But with this colour, you will need to apply two thin coats. And once you finish that base coat, you're now ready to edge highlight all the black using Eshin Grey. And with that black now finished, we've actually very nearly completed the miniature. We just have a few small details left to do. And the first of these is to paint the fragmentation charges, which have some green on them. And for this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Castellan Green, then we'll shade over them with Agrax Earthshade before finishing off with a highlight of Lauren Forest. So starting then with Castellan Green, apply to the medium layer brush once more, and as always, use your palette here so that we've got lots of control over the paint, because now we're working amongst lots of details that we've completed. So once you've got your mix ready, all you've got to do is start base coating these details, and the particular bomb we're looking at are these ones here, and there's one on either side. You just need to paint the ridged bit in the middle. Next, shade all over the green using Agrax Earthshade. And once that shade's dry, you're now ready to use Lauren Forest to highlight all these ridges. With those fragmentation charges now complete, we're ready to move on to what is really the final detail of the miniature, and that is the glowing energy that you can see in the endrons. Now for this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Thousand Suns Blue, and then we're going to layer over that using Araman Blue. After that, we'll do a thin coat of Baharoth Blue over the top of that to really lighten it up, after which we're going to be moving on to some glazes, but we'll come to those later, because first of all, we need Thousand Suns Blue. Now this I'm going to be applying with my medium layer brush, and what you want to get here is as smooth a coat as possible for the effect later on to work. So use your palette as always to make sure your paint's thinned down nicely. You want it about like that, and when you're ready, you're looking to base coat on these orbs, just being really neat as you get close to the brass around the outside of them. Once you finish that base coat, you're ready to apply a layer of Araman Blue. Now with this, you want to paint over most of the orb, just don't go right up to the corners. Leave a little bit of Thousand Suns Blue still showing in the very recess all the way around the orb. Next, we're ready to add a layer of thinned down Baharoth Blue, once again covering most of it, but leaving a little bit of Araman Blue and Thousand Suns Blue still showing around the edges. Once that first coat of Baharoth Blue was dry, I added a second one in the same way to get a nice bright finish in the middle there. And with that done, we're now ready to take the effect further on towards white, and so we've got to highlight it a bit more. But now, the colours are getting quite stark that we're going to be applying. So rather than applying them as we have been doing, we're going to start glazing them on. So we're going to begin with Althuin Grey, which we're going to mix with Lamium Medium, and then we're going to move on to White Scar, but once again, mixed with Lamium Medium. Now the reason why we're going to be using Lamium Medium here rather than water dilute our paint is because Lamium Medium is essentially paint with no pigment in it. So when we mix it with other paints, we retain the property of the paint whilst also diluting the colour. Using water in this way at this extent would start to break up the paint a little bit, and we'd get quite a scratchy looking effect to the finish here. We want it to be nice and soft. So I'm going to start out then with Althuin Grey, still with my medium layer brush to apply this, and what you want to do is just get some of this onto your palette, and then we're going to mix in some Lamia Medium in with it. You're looking for about 50-50 here, and always remember to clean your brush before you get the medium so you don't contaminate it with any pigment. So get a brush full there and then start mixing that in, and the kind of effect we're looking for, you're looking for it to be like this before you start to apply it. And when you're ready, what you do is paint this into mostly the same area we have been using so far, just close up to the edge to leave some of those darker blues on the outside there like that. And you will need to apply two coats, possibly three to build it up, but make sure they're thin so you get a nice soft effect as you go. Once you're happy with that built-up Ulthurn grey, it's time to repeat the process using White Scar. And once you're happy with the White Scar, well, you're ready to make the final assembly. Now, when you're sticking the miniature together, I recommend using superglue at this point. And when you come to basing it, remember to base it in the same way as the rest of your army. And with the final assembly made, this Grundstock Gunhauler is now ready to join the rest of the Kharadron fleet, take to the skies and escort the frigates and ironclads into battle. So remember, whenever you're painting a miniature like this, be sure to think about your sub-assemblies before you start actually putting any paint onto the miniature. In the case of this sky vessel, we kept the hull, the engine and also the crew separate to ensure we could get to all the detail. Now we chose to start out with all the metallic parts because we wanted to dry brush them, and dry brushing can be quite a messy technique, so if you do the same you'll find you'll be able to neaten up all the detail as you start base coating in further colours. And finally, when you make your final assembly, remember to use superglue for this. Don't use plastic glue, because if you do you'll start to melt all the paintwork and you could ruin your miniature if you're not careful. So there you go. Now we really hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and remember, all the techniques and methods we've shown you can be used to paint any of the Kharadron sky vessels that you want to paint. So we really hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll see you all again soon.